Hi, this is in response to Billy's Talking Points memo of Tuesday, October 21st, 2014, entitled Racist America. And again, Billy, you've done it again. You've done a great job. You've created the image that you're out there basically blaming the Democrats for playing the racist card, when you're actually the one that's playing the racist card. Now, this is how the scenario actually goes. Okay, so Howard Feynman on MSNBC talks about how it's implied, but it's never spoken, but those people who it's implied to understand it completely, that this is the way things go. And of course, Howard Feynman was not talking about racist America like everyone. No, Howard Feynman was not talking about Democrats. Howard Feynman was not talking about Republicans. Howard Feynman was not talking about independents. He was talking about a select group of people who are still racist, and many of them have come to power in Republican in states that the state government is run by Republicans, and that the state government is run by Republican governors, and that they have enacted laws which prevent people from voting. Voter ID law is one of them, and an example of that is, Billy, you were born in 1949. At that particular point in time, many black people in the United States, in the South, did not have birth certificates. Why? Because white hospitals would not let black people to the hospitals. So there were very few care facilities for blacks in the South at that time. And for many, obviously, after you were born, years after you were born, and years before you were born, that's the way that it was. Many of these people did not have a birth certificate. In many of the large cities, there are people of color who do not have full proper ID. I know it's hard to believe, but that's the way it is, right? And these Republican legislatures with Republican governors have enacted laws that will, in essence, prevent people of color, mostly black, but also Latinos, from voting. And just because MSNBC now is letting people know that these laws are going to hurt people from voting and can hurt a fair election in the United States, you're saying that they're saying that everyone in the United States is racist. And no, that's not the case at all. But that's how you do it. You take a little thing that's like this little big, and you make it so big. And it's not that big. But you exaggerate it past this wildest form. All right? So again, you indicate that that they're playing the race card. No, they're trying to get every individual who is eligible to vote, who wants to vote, to be able to vote. And of course, my answer to all of this, why don't we have a national ID? Yeah, why not? A United States national ID, right? That could be done. But give it 10 years, or give it 5 years, or give it however much time that is necessary, so that every single person can get an ID. And allow the government to do the outreach so that they can get people who don't normally have IDs to get IDs. Because not only do they say that people have to have IDs who don't have IDs. So if there's someone who's born in the South, a black person who's born the same that you were, Billy, 1949, who does not have a birth certificate, who wants to vote this year, how do they get a birth certificate? Well, that costs some money, because they got to go somewhere where they got to go to the DMV or the courthouse or something, and they may not live in the exact same area where they were born. It may be a bus ride, you know, and of course, then, like in Wisconsin, as an example, you know, you had to go to the DMV. And what did they do in heavily Democratic areas in Wisconsin where people had to go to the DMV to get their IDs? They closed them down 3 days a week or 4 days a week and made it even harder for people to get to. So this is not racist America. This is how you want to play it. So you want people to agree with you that Democrats aren't doing this, that are behind all this. No, it's your people that are behind this whole thing. It's your people who don't want people of color to vote, who don't want blacks to vote, who don't want Latinos to vote, and are going out of their way to find new and creative and innovative ways to keep people from voting, right? And then you want to get into Barack Obama, you know, because the blacks are going to vote in lockstep with the president. You know, well, here's the thing. You go on, and of course, this is how you play your race card. Oh, Barack Obama is a very liberal Democrat. No, he's not. He's pretty damn mainstream. In fact, he's been on the conservative side, and most of us who are true Democrats, as I like to say, you know, a liberal for a long time, is that, hey, he's not a liberal Democrat. He's not a liberal Democrat. Let's put it that way. And you know, then to tie it into the Ebola thing, you know, you go into too many places. But let's just say this is not a racist country. We have gone a long way. We still have a long way to go. And of course, here's the other thing. And this is the thing. You know, I've been on the golf course with people. I've been in cars with people going to different places. I've been at restaurants talking with people, and of course, I look like a Republican. And when people have trust, and they trust me, they tell me. They tell me that they're racist. They open up. Now, does everyone do it? No, of course not. Just a few people. But it's amazing how when a group of people are together, that and someone feels comfortable, they'll like throwing that stuff out, and. But there's not that many. No, of course not. But, you know, and it's not, but the thing is, and again, I want to get back to the point. You only want to bring up, hey, look at how they're playing the race card. They want the blacks to vote, you know. Look at Obama, he's so liberal. You know, they're playing the race card, you know. No, it's you guys playing the race card. You know, again, I can't express how vile it is of you as a human being, as a Harvard man, as a man who says that he is looking out for the folks, sit there and call us a racist nation, and then, you know, imply that black people, Democrats are trying to get black people to vote, and they shouldn't be voting. You know, I mean, you know how, you know, vile is that? And then here's the other thing on all that, and I'll end up with this, is that I know that you could pass a lie detector test to say that you're not racist. I know you would pass a lie detector test, right? But if anyone studied you and how it is deals with racism, yes, you have all of that as part of your psyche. You have so blocked out and so deeply blocked out, you know, who you are as a human being, you know. You have your shtick, you know. You have found what works for you. You have your ideology, you know, and you will fit everything to go with your ideology. And you will not backtrack. You will be steadfast. You are with this precept 100%. But again, studying it, yes, you would qualify as a racist.